Hi, Mike here again. Welcome back to the tank restoration facility and the introduction of our M36 tank destroyer. Our goal is to restore this back to running and driving condition. This tank is based on the earlier version M10A1 tank destroyer hull. It's combined with the M4 suspension and drivetrain. This M36 tank is known to be one of nine still in existence worldwide that was manufactured by the Fisher Tank Division of GM in 1944. All total, 300 M36 Fisher body tanks were built. This is number 300 in all the series, and it's one of four known to be in the United States. Other manufacturers were Massey Harris, American Locomotive Company, and Montreal Locomotive Works. Total built was 2,324. This tank originally served in Europe during World War II, eventually making its way to Yugoslavia between the years 53 and 57 as part of the mutual defense aid program used by Allied forces, and remained in service through the 1990s. During its service in Yugoslavia, it was retrofitted with a Russian-made V-55, a V-12 diesel engine producing 580 horsepower with a cubic displacement of 3,270. Prior to its retrofit, it was powered by the Ford GAA V8 gas engine producing 500 horsepower and 1,100 foot-pounds of torque through 2,200 RPM. It was 1,100 cubic inch displacement. Both versions utilized the synchromesh, non-neutral steer, 5-speed forward and 1-speed reverse transmission made by Spicer. It's armed with an M3 90mm main gun and 50 cal heavy barrel machine gun. And at this point, I'd like to stop and explain this barrel up on top here that you're seeing is from the M3A1 version, which is a later model. So we'll have to be making concessions and fixing that and replacing that. We're going to restore this back to World War II configuration with a Ford GAA engine. When done with this tank, we'll join the existing vehicles in our Dubois parade lineup. And here's what you're going to see. As we continue to strip the M36, we'll be recording our progress and sharing it with you. Our first set of videos will focus on the removal of the engine, the main gun, the turret, and powertrain. And as we work, while doing so, videos will be made following the steps for each component and a breakdown of some of those individual processes that were most interesting. As you'll see, we're underway having removed the hull, access panels, radiator fans, starter, and linkages to the engine. Every component will be tagged, cleaned, disassembled, and inspected to determine its path forward. We'll determine if it's complete, identify worn or broken parts, identify what is to be replaced by sourcing or made in-house. Usable parts will continue on for in-depth cleaning and sandblasting or placed in storage for additional mock-up needs as we gather parts. After final mock-up, everything is prepped and painted finally. Now let's move over and look at some of the points of interest. The first point of interest I'd like to view in on is the suspension. It is a VVSS, the Vertical Volute Spring Suspension. Obviously, in its name, the volute springs go up and down. Other versions of that would be the horizontal, which go horizontally, which you'll see on our M4 version of this tank. It's got a 12-inch wide track assembly. It's got a total of 12 volute springs that suspend this whole tank on its own. Two of them for each set of bogey wheels. Next thing we're going to focus in on is the turret. The turret is an open top type module. We have a cover for it that was produced with it. Some theaters used it, some theaters didn't. What you'll see when you get inside, when we get inside there, is a demilled gun that's actually out of battery. We have removed the breech block assembly as it's been demilled also. All that stuff will come back and go back together, but we're gonna change out this gun tube, as I mentioned before. You will see that most of the stuff is inside there. You can see the ammo racks, the elevation and depression mechanism is still intact. all in all, it's just a pretty basic form of turret. Now let's move over to the engine compartment. As you can see, we've removed access panels to expose the Russian V55 V12 engine, which we're going to replace with our GAA. You can see by looking in here that linkages have been removed, fan components have been removed, radiators are still installed back in the rear of it, and it's about ready to be pulled out. We'll have further films on that to show you as we move along. And now I'd like to talk to you about the clutch. As you can see, it's exposed with all the access panels off of it for us to remove it. As you can see on this, the flywheel meshes with the starter assembly, which is not on the engine block as traditionally expected. It is in the bottom of the hull, turned backwards, so it interfaces with the flywheel. We've taken all this apart so we can get the engine separated from it so we can get it out the hull. And we're really excited to bring you our restoration projects like this M36 tank destroyer. As we move through the processes, we're going to have more videos to present to you as we go through the component breakdowns all the way through final paint. Thanks for being with us, and tune in to future videos.